Microphone manufacturers make an effort to help us understand how a microphone performs by supplying a polar pattern graph. But if you struggle to read these illustrations, they can be nothing more than lines and squiggles on a page. If you'd like to know how to make sense of these details, then stick around and I'll take the mystery out of the polar pattern. G'day, my name is Gary and you're watching the YouTube channel Simple Audio Tips, dedicated to make sound gear easy to understand. The polar pattern graph tells us a lot about a microphone's sensitivity to sound, coming from different directions. Now let's have a closer look at this chart. The chart has three different measurements. The first one is the radial lines. Like the directions of a compass indicate direction in degrees, these lines radiating from the center indicate sound coming from different directions. 0 degrees represents sound that is on axis, or sound going into the front of the microphone. 90 degrees and 270 degrees, sound entering the sides of the microphone, and 180 degrees, sounds coming from the direction of the back. Each circular division on this chart represents measurements of sensitivity, and this gives you an idea of where the microphone picks up sound the best and in which direction it's less sensitive to sound. The circle on the outside is marked 0 dB. Now don't be confused. This represents the loudest or strongest level of sound expected from the microphone. The center circle is minus 25 dB, or the quietest. Now the wriggly line or drawing, and the thing that's called a plot, is calculated when the microphone is tested for its sensitivity. In reality, this line is only an average of one frequency, and real life tests reveal that it's never smooth. But of course, it's only meant to be a relative representation of how the mic performs. Some graphs even show more than one frequency by laying them on top of each other and changing the line style or colour. Look, to show you how this works, I'll use a microphone with a very basic pickup pattern, and with the knowledge that you gain, you should be able to apply it to more complex polar pattern microphones yourself. This is the polar pattern for a cardioid microphone. By the way, the name cardioid comes from the heart-like shape of the polar pattern line. Cardioid microphones are known to reject sound coming from the back and are good in a situation like a stage performance where you don't want sound from your speakers returning back into the mic. Now you can see this on the graph. The front of the mic indicates 0 dB, or the strongest. Sound coming toward the back of the mic is measured at minus 25. That's 25 decibels less. Now, so you get an idea of what this means in real terms, I'm going to simulate the difference in sensitivity when sound comes from different directions. This is the level of sound picked up from the front of the microphone. This is the level of sound that's picked up by the side of the microphone. And this simulates the level of sound coming into the back of the microphone. So you can hear for yourself, there's a considerable difference in pickup between the front and the back. And this is illustrated on the polar pattern. You shouldn't have any problem at all working out from a microphone's polar pattern how it's going to perform when you set it up for recording or stage performance. If that hasn't cleared up the mystery of the polar pattern, you can add your questions in the comments section below this video. There's often some great ideas and discussion from subscribers just like yourself, so check it out. And if you like this video, then give us a thumbs up. And if this is your first time that you've watched a video from our channel and you'd like to learn more about sound gear in a simple and easy to understand format, then go ahead and subscribe. Or you could follow our updates on your favourite social media app. Now remember, you don't have to be a sound engineer to learn the basics of improving your audio. Sounds easy with Simple Audio Tips. Until next time, I'll catch you later.